On June 20th, 1987, the governor of Agri proclaims to the world that the Turkish archaeological authorities confirmed the findings of the Ron Wyatt expedition and declare the area under investigation the landing site of the legendary Noah's Ark. Ron's contribution to this discovery earns him VIP status as he actively participates in the dedication of the site. Dr. Arthur Brandenberger, a stereophotogrammetry expert, accompanies the group to the region. After studying the object and comparing the measurements to those in the aerial photos, he states, "I have no doubt at all that the object is a ship. In my entire career, I have never seen an object like this on a stereo photo."
And here we are at last, gazing upon the mortal remains of the great boat that Noah and his family rowed to safety.
When I arrived at the boat-shaped object, I was amazed at how much it looked like a boat. If you've ever seen a boat that had a hole in it and had partially sunk down to where just the railings of the boat were above the water, this is exactly what I saw sitting out there on that mountainside.
Dr. William Shea of the Biblical Research Institute of Washington, D.C., assists in analyzing the data from the Wyatt expedition.
The formation that we have, as it's been surveyed both from aerial photographs and on the ground, is 150 meters long, or almost 500 feet, as measured to essentially what would be 300 cubits long. Now that's a remarkable correspondence. It's not 500 cubits, it's not 150 cubits, it just happens to be 300 cubits long. And the biblical story just happens to record the length of the ark as 300 cubits long.
A literally earth-shattering breakthrough takes place.
My disappointment at having to wait on a permit for a later date was offset by an earthquake that happened in 1978 that did a much better job of excavating the boat than I could have done in maybe a year or 2 years hard work.
The earthquake drops the veil of soil from along one side of the boat's remains, leaving exposed the timber-shaped ribs of the ancient vessel. Here, at 6,300 feet above sea level, in the mountains of Ararat, lies what appears to be the hull of a massive, ancient, man-made ship. The sides of the object clearly exposed, the outline of the hull as evident now as the object's incredible mass.
There was a vertical split right down the center of the boat, which enabled me to measure the depth of the boat, plus get good, clean, fresh sample material out of there to have analyzed to tell us more about the chemical composition of the boat.
Samples are taken from the near vicinity as well to identify any significant differences in quantities of trace chemicals. The samples are rushed back to the United States, where they are immediately analyzed. The results are electrifying. A high carbon content in the soil taken from where the boat's timbers are exposed provides evidence of long decayed wood. Traces of metal are detected, revealing the possibility of objects such as metal supports. These are the first factual signs that the object is not simply a natural phenomenon, but may prove to be man-made. Five field research specialists, including Dr. John Baumgartner, a physicist from Los Alamos National Laboratories, accompany Ron on his next expedition. Using metal detection devices, they construct from the evidence gathered the unmistakable pattern, the regular features delineating a symmetrical, internal, subsurface structure of massive proportions. Four different types of metal detectors are used. All produce positive readings, translated here into visually observable features. No positive results occur in the readings taken outside the boat-shaped area. Dr. Shea.
If you had petrified wood in this formation, and the petrification takes place by a process of mineral elements flowing through the wood and depositing in them, then you would expect the trace readings that those minerals would give to follow the pattern of the decayed timbers and the petrification process. And so one possibility would be that this is a reflection of the petrification process of an original form, which would underlay this formation as it now stands.
The Wyatt expedition receives the necessary government permits to perform the radar examinations. The results are staggering. Massive keelsons, deck timbers, open chambers, and other nautical configurations appear before their eyes, telling the story of what specialists believe to be the remains of an enormous, ancient, man-made ship.
Basically, the radar scans show the same thing that the metal detector scans did, only with more detail. They show there is a pattern. They show there's a pattern of linear lines, there's a pattern of cross lines, and there's a pattern of even distribution to these lines in both directions. Now, that's precisely what you would expect out of the remains of a ship-type object, because you would have a keel, you would have parallel lines, which would be keelsons, and you would have the transverse lines, which would be bulkheads and other reinforcing of the ship.
Delighted with the results, and at this point in time, personally, I can look anybody in the eye and say that this boat-shaped formation in eastern Turkey is actually the remains of Noah's Ark.